Going against her doctor's advice, woman is pregnant with 22nd child.
But before we start, please make sure to subscribe and hit the bell so you never miss an upload from us. Also, leave a like right now.
Sue Radford was 14 when she had her first child, and she didn't stop there, eventually giving birth to a total of 21 kids. But why did she decide to have so many? And how exactly do Sue and her husband Noel support them financially? It's time to address all the fascinating stories behind their decisions, as well as one more surprise that's well on its way. Hopefully you're good with names, because it's time to meet the Radford family in its entirety. First, we've got Noel and Sue, the overjoyed parents of the clan, ages 49 and 44 respectively. Then for the kids, there's Chris, who's 30, Sophie, 26, Chloe, 24, Jack, 22, Daniel, 20, Luke, 19, Millie, 18, Katie, 17, James, 16, Ellie, 14, Amy, 13, Josh, 12, Max, 11, Tilly, 9, Oscar, 8, Casper, 7, Haley, who's 4, 3-year-old Phoebe, 2-year-old Archie, and 1-year-old Bonnie. It should be noted that in 2014, Sue gave birth to Alfie, who was a stillborn. In his honor, they still count him when telling people how many kids they have, saying they have 21 kids and not 20. But what inspired them to have such a giant family? With one more on the way right now, will this finally be the last one? Noel told The Sun in an interview, "I don't think anyone sets out thinking they'll have 21 children. We thought we'd have 3, but we just love having a family." After welcoming their 20th child, the happy parents declared, "This is definitely the last one, isn't it?" Today, the Radford family lives in Morecambe, a seaside town in northwest England. Noel and Sue had one of those classic love stories you usually see only in movies. They first met each other when they were only 7 years old, with their families living in neighboring cul-de-sacs. Even at this young age, their chemistry was something special, and it was enough to spark a romance that's lasted over 40 years. When Noel was 18 and Sue was just 14, she became pregnant with their first child. Sue was at a shockingly young age to have a baby. After all, you're not even of age yourself when you're 14. There are so many things you aren't allowed to do legally, let alone be responsible for another life. But even though they were so young at the time, they made the decision to keep the baby. And they had a good reason, too. Both Noel and Sue had been given up for adoption when they were born. This fact of their life histories meant that they therefore felt a strong desire to hold on to the baby that they had. But after having their eldest son, Chris, their circumstances of their lives weren't exactly so simple. And so these two very young lovers decided to keep their baby and to stay together as well. However, that didn't necessarily mean they were allowed to get married. In the United Kingdom, as in many other countries, the law prohibits minors under 16 from getting hitched without parental consent. And in some places, you have to wait until you're 18. That's precisely what Noel and Sue did. 4 years after giving birth to Chris, when Sue was 18 and Noel was 22, the happy young couple of parents finally tied the knot on September 26, 1991. At that point, one might think they'd try to settle in and focus on raising their lone child, but it wasn't long before they were expecting Sophie, their number two. As they say, one should never underestimate the power of momentum. Now that the young couple were finally married, they felt that nothing could place limits on them. After Sophie arrived, they just kept having more and more kids. Just over a year later, Chloe was born, and 2 years after that, they were already welcoming their fourth kid, Jack. A year and a half later, it was Daniel, and following his birth, they would proceed to have a baby pretty much every year after that for the next 16 years. But that leaves an uncomfortable question. Ask any woman who's ever given birth, and she'll tell you that this must have taken quite a toll on Sue's body. So how'd she manage to do it? Was something like this recommended? On November 6, 2018, a 43-year-old Sue gave birth to her and her husband's 21st child, Bonnie Ray. They explained, "Her middle name is because she's our ray of sunshine." Amazingly, when Sue got to the hospital, she was only in labor for a shocking total of 12 minutes. When you're as practiced at birthing as she is, the process surely takes far less time. Sue had spent an astonishing 811 weeks throughout her entire life being pregnant, conceding, "It has to come to an end at some point." After having Bonnie, the midwives at the hospital jokingly asked her if she'd be returning the next year, and her response was, "Definitely not." She also planned on cutting ties with long-held sentimental items like her maternity clothes, the crib, and baby bottles. As serious as Sue was with her motives, the children had heard that line from her plenty of times before. Second-born Sophie joked that her parents wouldn't stop on an odd number. While third-born Chloe struggled, they might not plan on having another, but it could still happen. The Radford children seemed to think that they knew their parents better than even their parents knew themselves. That's right, after all the constant reassurance that they were done having kids, Noel and Sue posted a YouTube video telling the world that they were expecting their 22nd child. In the video, Sue excitedly proclaimed, "Basically, today we're going to see our new little baby. I'm 12 weeks pregnant, so we're gonna go and have a little peek at the new little Radford." She made the announcement with such a melodious flavor in her voice that it's obvious just how much she loves having kids. As of now, the due date for baby Radford is April of 2020. However, there were actually some complications with this pregnancy. Throughout the early stages of Sue's latest pregnancy, there were some health concerns that the baby wasn't growing quickly enough. It didn't matter how many kids they already had, every life is precious and fragile, and it was doubtlessly a hard time for them to go through. But thankfully, the baby's trajectory took a positive turn in the later months, and Sue enthusiastically described the baby's rapid movement and growth. If all goes well, that would give them a total of 22 kids. But how are they going to manage it? And for that matter, how have they been able to support these kids financially for all these years? It's fascinating to learn about Sue and Noel's typical day with their large batch of little ones. They wake up every morning at 6:30 a.m. Every breakfast, the family goes through 18 pints of milk, 3 liters of juice, and 3 boxes of cereal. Then they must send their children on ferries to 3 separate schools and 1 preschool. Having 21 children is beautiful in theory, but it's certainly far from being free. When they go out for dinner, they have to pay at least $190. Going to the movies can run a price tag of about $130. Sue explained to the publication Female, "We do like to go to the cinema, especially in the holidays when the kids are a bit bored, but it can be up to $13 per person, so it can work out really expensive." With multiple tuitions to pay, the $325 a week in groceries, utility bills, and everything else we already mentioned, one may wonder how they're able to pay for everything. Well, it turns out that the majority of the Radfords' income come from their longtime pie business, Radford's Pie Company. Noel, a master of pies, has been baking them for 25 years and seems to have built himself such a great reputation that business is thriving. However, there's also the television documentary that they've appeared on from time to time, which undoubtedly provided them with a nice stipend. In addition to all that, they reportedly received $225 a week in child benefits from the government. Their house is also one of their biggest assets. The Radford family home in Morecambe is a 10-bedroom house which they bought for roughly $312,000 in 2014. It's more than big enough to hold their small community of children, yet even with the house's impressive size, anyone who's ever had children knows how messy things can get, so you can imagine what it's like for them. Sue confirmed on Instagram, "With so many people living in this house, things get messy very quickly. Considering the fact that the laundry machine works non-stop in their house, it's probably the same when it comes to cleaning. At least they have an army of children to help with the chores. But when it comes to this family, everything seems to be fun for them." As the Radford family grew and grew, eventually they were recognized as Britain's largest family. This title alone catapulted them into another level of fandom, with plenty of the children garnering their own individual followings on social media as well. On Instagram, the Radford's official page currently holds a following of 212,000, with third-born daughter Chloe holding a personal fan base of nearly 24,000. They're celebrities in their own right, but with a different kind of spotlight, one that isn't accompanied by red carpet dresses and Oscar wins. It's the type of adoration that regular citizens can truly relate to. The Radfords are all about family, and ultimately, a lot of people can agree that family is a worthy common denominator to aspire to.